Oh, cause some came in the mail today.
Yeah, I did.
It's the nut job. I know I've been putting this off for a little bit longer than you expected, but here it is. This movie is like if you put over the hedge's squirrel animations and bulk of the plot, then you take the clunky animation from Open Season and the toilet humor from that as well, then you take the latter of the plot of Rango, and then you put it all in that little blender right there. You see that blender? And then you get the nut job. We're gonna have a certain happen to these nuts. We're not talking about Alvin, and we're not talking about some black guy, and we're not talking about the nut chat. We're talking about squirrels. Nuts. And how none of this flows well together. The problem with this movie is that it stars an asshole. Now, the main character of this story, his name is Surly. Surly the Squirrel. And he is voiced by Will Arnett. Wanna know what else Will Arnett voiced in? He was Lego Batman in both the Lego movie and the Lego Batman movie. Wow, Will Arnett, you really are flexible with your jobs. Wish I be that flexible. Then there's Andy, the stereotype of, I'm the woman who's independent and can do, and is the smartest character of the bunch. His buddy Buddy, the mouse, who's just a silent character. Way to have a movie with a silent character. Then you have these three groundhogs. And this mole, and then you have Grayson. Grayson is the typical, I'm better than you because I'm a hero and I'm also an airhead. Yes, he's both a hero and an airhead. In fact, he's not even a hero. He's just an airhead who prances around and tries to be a hero. Yet we never even saw any of the heroic things he's done. And he's played by Brendan Fraser. So, at the beginning of this movie, both Andy and Surly are both trying to steal from a nut cart, but run by these criminals. Basically, the nut cart goes out of control and crashes into the only tree that houses all the nuts for winter. And so the entire park decides to exile Squirrely. Surly. But led by Raccoon. Now, Raccoon is an interesting character because he is basically, he's the basic, I was the villain the whole time kind of thing. But the thing is, and he's voiced by William Neeson. You want to know where he's from? He's from that movie Taken, you know. I don't know who you are, I don't know where you are, but I have a particularly lack of skill. That movie. So, picture is Lego Batman talking with the guy from Taken. So, on back to what we're talking about. So, once Squirrely gets exiled, he finds a nut store. But not without getting hit around a bunch of times, a failed attempt of slapstick. And because the animation isn't so fluent, which means that it's not fluent, everything is so stilted. You see, in a 3D movie, you have to have fluent animation, or else it just looks like you're prancing around a bunch of ragdolls. But they find the nut shop. After a bunch of failed attempts to get in, they finally get into a roof. Then we learn about the subplot. Apparently, the people running the nut shop are criminals, and they want to rob a bank that's completely on the other side of the nut shop. Yeah, this subplot, it doesn't need to be here. No, this, and all it does is prove that they did not have enough plot to fill this 90-minute movie. Actually, I would think it. So, back to the bulk of the plot. So Andy and Grayson decide they have to go out into the city to search for food, and Grayson gets kidnapped by rats, leaving Andy to fend for herself until she finds the nut shop. So, once Surly and Buddy run into all the nuts in the basement, however, they run into the pug, and they first steal the whistle that controls the pug, which apparently also irritates this guy, one of the criminals, but then, Andy finds him, struggling to get out of the half, and then she pins him down for a barrel, just so the park can get some of the nuts. Yeah, and then he uses the whistle, and it turns out the pug can talk, and it decides to join the crew. Yeah, that's a real nice plan you got there. A real fucking tree. Now, here's where everything starts to clump together. What happens is that they try to intersplice the robbery plot with the main story. And it doesn't work out in the slightest. And we get a lot of bit to toilet humor in the heat between. It's quite the treat. If you don't like intelligence, or decency, or common sense. So, we learn that back at the park, after Andy gives out nuts, we learn that Raccoon is trying to control the amount of food in the park so that he can have total control. That was the same motivation that the turtle had in Rango. See, they rip off Rango just so they have a stupid plot point to loose end everything together. Now, and how the dog joins them is just like how the dog abruptly joins the animals on open season. Like, it's no. And this was made in 2014. Open season's animation was kind of acceptable because it was made in 2006. And back then, standards weren't that high yet. But this is just I'm not gonna make it through this, am I? Anyway, So Raccoon wants Sabotage, and so he asks Mole to sabotage the tunnels with the hose water. When Surly finds out it's Mole and wants to tattle on him. Everyone else doesn't believe him. Big surprise. Now, Surly has been a jerk throughout this entire film. He's even been a jerk to a point past, I don't want to like this guy anymore. Like, he is petty. Like, he doesn't deserve this nut prize of his. So apparently, he even scolds his buddy who doesn't talk. Now, if this guy was the guy who stuck with you for the entire film, why did you tell him off? Because you're a jerk. This just adds on to your jerkness. Sorry, it's just that this film doesn't really click. So anyway, as we keep going, we learn that where was I? Let me check my script. Yes. So after that, Grayson just appears out of nowhere. Like, why? Wow. So, Grayson didn't die. He's just living out there on his own. And apparently now he's going crazy because he's gotten too many hits on the head. So then they just part ways and both have their own plan. Surly gets trapped inside with the humans, and then the other animals get found out by Raccoon, and then Raccoon traps them in the back of the van with the criminals. Then the police chase happens. Surly and Grayson come in to try and save the day, and the dumber criminals decide they've been had, and then it just comes to clumping together, everything crowded into each other, it's just so cluttered, what? And none of it flows together with any sorts of consistency. At least with Open Season, it had a consistent plot. The animation may not be the best, but at least it's consistent. And with Rango, at least you may not be able to identify the characters that well, but at least the story and the atmosphere is great. And with Over the Hedge, you got a bunch of stuff happening at once. And you got that DreamWorks magic. This has none of that. It's just rehashing a bunch of old movies just so it can make a quick buck off of it. And I haven't even talked about the ending yet. Oh, yeah. So apparently, Surly tries to save Andy. Because apparently, we have to have a love interest. So then they go over the falls, and then Raccoon tries to kill Surly. Big surprise. And then, so Surly lets go of the dog whistle that was keeping him alive. And him and Raccoon go over the falls. Now here's my question of it. After this movie, after seeing it a couple times, I had to watch this a couple times. I don't feel sympathy for Surly. I feel like he got what he deserved. Like, I feel like going over the falls was a good karma. It's just like, but of course, so nuts come flying down the river into the park, and all the animals come back to the park. The criminals get arrested, big surprise, and then Buddy the rat actually says best friend to his buddy's corpse. But Surprise of all surprises, Surly is still alive. Whoop de fucking do. The thing is, here, kids. When you're going to decide your movie for the year, make sure you do some good research. Oh, and I may have a fine brain! This movie makes you drive and go nuts. It's all about these nuts. It's about the nuts in your head. It's about the nut shack. It's about the nuts. They're nuts! Fucking nuts! It's all about the nuts. And here's the thing. So Surly decides to be good, and from now on, he decides to get nuts for the park for good. This was a hard thing for me to review. Not because of just the clunky animation, twirl humor, and obvious references. Oh, I forgot. During the credits, Psy makes an appearance. What? Why? And also, yeah, this thing also had Psy music in it. And Psy was dated by 2014. Do some research! Please. This is worse than any of the other things I review. It's worse than Hallblart Mockup 2. It's worse than Super Noobs. It's worse than Cat's Fancy. Like, seriously. Don't go nuts. It's finally over. Maybe now I've mastered reviewing. Maybe there are some other things to review. Oh my god, what the fuck is that? What are that?